What is good, YouTube? Jake here with Venture Visuals, and we are back at it again with another tutorial. I hope everybody's having a good holiday season. Today, I couldn't be more stoked to be showing you guys how to apply this Saber effect within Photoshop. Saber is mostly known as an After Effects plugin, but today I'm gonna be showing you guys how to get this same effect and apply it to your thumbnails, apply it to your graphic design. It's gonna be dope. When I say Saber, I'm talking about a plugin that creates these glowing lines around objects. It's a free plugin that you can use in After Effects, and I do wanna mention that we are gonna be using After Effects to get this effect today, but we're gonna be bringing our file back into Photoshop from After Effects. So if you're stoked to learn how to apply this Saber glowing line effect in Photoshop, hit the like button down below and let's get hyped up. I'm gonna apply the glowing line effect around this picture of Lil Uzi Vert. So as you can see over here in my right panel, you can see we have the Lil Uzi Vert layer and the background layer, which is just the space layer, which highly recommend checking out a website called Unsplash if you're looking for dope backgrounds and stuff. I'll include a link below. But the first step we're gonna do is just take this picture of Lil Uzi Vert, and we're gonna get rid of the background. So what we're gonna do is come up here to this quick selection tool, and we're just gonna hit select subject. And what that's gonna do is it's automatically gonna select our subject. Now what you'll notice is that it doesn't get the edges perfectly, so we wanna make sure that we just highlight over some of these edges so that it doesn't cut anything out. And there could be areas that you see get outlined that you don't want. All you have to do is hold option and trace over those areas, and that'll just get rid of those areas. Once you have a perfect outline around whatever it is that you're tracing, all you're gonna do is come down here to this square icon with a circle in it, and you're just gonna hit it once. What that's gonna do is it's gonna create what we like to call a mask. So after I zoom out, you can really see that we have a dope looking thumbnail already. So what we're gonna do is just get rid of the background layer. Just delete this white layer for now. We don't even need it at all. And we're just gonna hide this space layer. So all we have now is just this cutout of Lil Uzi Vert. So now what I'm gonna do is hit File, Export, quick export as PNG, and I'm gonna save it to my desktop here at the top left, and we're gonna call this Lil Uzi Cutout. We're gonna hit enter to save. So this checkered texture in the background here, that just means that our background is transparent. The only object on this file is going to be the face. We're gonna hop into Adobe After Effects. So here in Adobe After Effects, I have a blank composition. What we need to do first is just import our file. So double click in this project panel over here. We're gonna come up to desktop, and as you can see, we have the Lil Uzi Vert cutout PNG. Just drag that down into our timeline here, and now we have it perfect. So now for the fun part, what we're gonna do is just take this cutout, we're gonna come up here to our layer tab, and we're gonna come down to Autotrace. We're just gonna hit current frame. Since this is a static image, we only need it to trace one frame, okay? And you'll see that it creates a bunch of points around our image. Take this Autotrace layer and drag it below our image, right? What we need to do now is come up here to our effects and presets tab and just find our effect called Saber. Now Saber is a free plugin. I'll include a link for it below. You can get it for After Effects. And all we're gonna do is drag this Saber plugin onto the Autotrace layer right here. And the first thing I like to do before anything else is just open up the customize core tab and change it from Saber to layer masks. Now you can see we get this dope glow behind our object, and there is a million different ways to showcase your glow. As you can see, a lot of different options here under the preset tab. So you can control how bright this line is, how dark it is, how refined it is. It's all under your control. We need to come down to where it says render settings. From here, we gotta change the composite settings from black to transparent, and this is gonna save our transparent background. So let's go ahead and change it to something like Energize. I love Energize. I think it's one of the best looking line options that they have on the Saber plugin, and I think it just looks very dope. So I'm just gonna tweak it a little bit, make it look really cool, and we can toggle the transparency grid right down here. This way it becomes easier to see because we can switch between a black background and a transparent background. So this actually looks fairly dope. Go ahead and turn our transparency grid back on. So now we have that transparent background again. We're gonna drag our work area end all the way so that we're only going to render this first frame. So we're gonna come up here to composition, come down to render queue, add to render queue, change our output module from QuickTime to a PNG sequence, and we want to make sure that it says RGB plus alpha. Alpha just stands for transparency. We want it to keep the transparent background behind it. Now, when we render it as a PNG sequence, it's going to render it as a static transparent file, just like how we rendered a quick PNG out in Photoshop. So we're just going to keep it as PNG sequence, RGB plus alpha. You can come to color management, hit preserve RGB, and we're gonna hit okay. So we wanna make sure that this saves to the desktop. So we're gonna say Lil Uzi Vert Glow, and you can see it's going to save straight to my desktop. We're gonna hit save, and we're gonna hit render. Boom, it's that easy. So now that we have it rendered, we're gonna hop back here into Adobe Photoshop. You can see we have the old version of Lil Uzi Vert without the glow. So what we need to do is go up here to file, and we're gonna come down to place embedded, and that is gonna open up on our desktop right here. So from our desktop, I don't see the glow file, but I do see this comp one folder. So I'm gonna double click on that. This is just something that After Effects does. It likes to save these PNG files to folders. So obviously it's called comp one. I double click on that folder, and here is the Lil Uzi Vert with the glow outline. I'm gonna go ahead and hit place, and boom, just like that, you can see the difference. So let's go ahead and take a look at the before and the after. So this is the before, and this is the after. So obviously big upgrades here on your thumbnail, guys. This is a perfect effect to use for any type of video, just to make sure that your thumbnail pops. Now I'm gonna give you guys a little bonus tip as well with this video. So what I like to do after I have the going line in the thumbnail how I want it in Photoshop, I just like to save it to my desktop. So we're just gonna go ahead and save this to my desktop. And we're gonna go ahead and make sure that that's just saving to my desktop. I'm gonna hit save. Hit okay. And now I'm gonna reveal one of my biggest hacks for dope thumbnails. So a lot of people, I don't think, realize how powerful Adobe Lightroom is. And if you have the Creative Cloud, I highly recommend downloading Lightroom Classic. So we're just gonna go ahead and hop right into Adobe Lightroom. So as you can see, I've done a lot of thumbnail work in Adobe Lightroom here. But what we're gonna do is just come down to this import button at the bottom left. And we're just gonna go ahead and click it once. And we're gonna go ahead and find our thumbnail. So as you can see right here, we have the PSD Lil Uzi Vert Glow thumbnail. We're gonna go ahead and check that box and hit import. So this is just gonna import our thumbnail directly into Adobe Lightroom Classic. And now what I can do is hit develop. This is where Adobe Lightroom Classic is so powerful, because you can change the colors so easily. You can make your thumbnails pop out even more. And it's a lot easier, in my opinion, than just using Adobe Photoshop. So that's why I like the combination of Adobe Photoshop and Adobe Lightroom. So on the right, you can see we have all these settings for changing the colors, for changing the different tones and the different aspects of the image itself. And then on the left, I have a bunch of user presets that I've created. And if I just scroll over each preset, we get different looks for each preset. So obviously, these are just filters you can download and put into Adobe Lightroom that will save you time. And you can actually get these same presets on my website, ventervisuals.com. And I really love these presets because it saves me so much time when I'm editing thumbnails and photos. Every preset has different settings. So for example, I like this digital banner preset. If I just click on it, you can see that it changes the settings over here on the right to give it a certain look. So this is just a preset filter that I've created from a past photo or thumbnail, and now I can apply these same effects onto this new thumbnail. So I have a bunch of different options here, guys, over 50 options. One of my favorites to use is this thumbnail sauce. I also really like VVS, so let's just roll with the VVS for now, and we're just gonna go ahead and boost that clarity up a little bit so it's a little bit sharper image. What I like to do is just adjust the curve a little bit so it's a little brighter in the middle and a little darker in the shadows. And then I just like to take the highlights down a little bit. The cool thing about Adobe Lightroom is that it's so easy to preview the before and after. All you gotta do is come down here to this double Y box right here. And now you can see the true difference that Adobe Lightroom makes. So you can see on the left side, this is our raw Photoshop file. And then on the right side is our Adobe Lightroom edited thumbnail. Big upgrade here. What I like to do from here is just hit file, export. I make sure that it's exporting to my desktop. I make sure that the file format is a JPEG. I don't resize it at all. I have the resolution set at 300 and then I just hit export. So now if I close out of Lightroom and I'll go ahead and minimize Photoshop, minimize After Effects, and I'm here on my desktop, you can see that we have the final thumbnail saved to our desktop. Seems a little complicated, but after you do it a few times, it's really easy peasy. I'm telling you, it's a great way to give your thumbnail some pizzazz and make people click. If any of you guys are video editors who are looking to add some more pizzazz to your videos or your thumbnails, check out my website, ventervisuals.com. I got Lightroom presets, I got light leaks, I got transitions, I got Saber transitions, I got animation overlays, a bunch of stuff on there, and you can try it all completely for free. So definitely check that out. I'll include a link below. Guys, I just wanna let you know that I really appreciate y'all tuning into my channel. I'm trying to grow this community, I'm trying to help my fellow creatives out there get better. And if you're one of those people who loves creating dope visuals and making dope edits, make sure to consider hitting that subscribe button down below. This community is only getting bigger and we're only going to keep helping each other out. We're going to be creating some dope edits this year. It's going to go crazy. The tutorials are going to go crazy. I'm so excited for this year. Man, 2022, we're coming at you. So definitely consider hitting that subscribe button down below. And I really appreciate it again, guys. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Jake Venner. Peace out. Yeah.